Good morning. Welcome to Advent Worship Service number 4, and Merry Christmas Eve to you all. Glad to have you here today. Everything you need for service today should be in your bulletins, and if there are any special instructions as we go along, we'll be sure to shout those out. Hopefully many of you have the little kind of heavy paper ornaments. Those will go onto this beautiful tree, light it up front, our Jesse tree, toward the very end of service, and we'll kind of help you along with that. So thanks for participating. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who comes to wake us from sleep, who leads us into the light of grace.
Amen.
Let us prepare the way of the Lord by confessing our sin against God and neighbor.
We confess.
God of all time,
we confess that we have not prepared for your merciful reign among us. We ignore our neighbors in need and fail in the labor of justice and peace. In your mercy, forgive us. Grant us wisdom to welcome your light and to seek the things that will endure until Christ comes again in glory. Amen.
Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. In Jesus Christ, all of our sins are forgiven and all things are made new. Rejoice in this good news.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
The second candle reminds us of our joy in proclaiming Christ as our mighty God. The third candle grants us comfort knowing that Jesus is our Prince of Peace. We light the fourth candle to remind us that Jesus is our everlasting Father, In a world of change, mobility, and transition, we affirm that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Thank you. The first reading is from 2 Samuel, 7th chapter. Now, when the king was settled in his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all of the enemies around him, the king said to the prophet Nathan, "See now, I am living in a house of cedar, but the ark of God stays in a tent." Nathan said to the king, "Go, do all that you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But the same night, the word of the Lord came to Nathan, "Go and tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, are you the one to build me a house to live in? I have not lived in a house since the day I brought up the people of Israel from Egypt to this day, but I have been moving about in a tent and a tabernacle. Wherever I have moved about among all the people of Israel, did I ever speak a word with any of the tribal leaders of Israel, whom I commanded to shepherd my people Israel, saying, 'Why have you not built me a house of cedar?' Now, therefore, thus you shall say to my servant David, 'Thus says the Lord of hosts, I took you from the pasture, from following the sheep, to be a prince over my people Israel. And I have been with you wherever you went, and have cut off all your enemies from before you. And I will make you a great name, like the name of the great ones of the earth. And I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and I will plant them, so that they may live in their own place and be disturbed no more. And evildoers shall afflict them no more, as formerly from the time that I appointed judges over my people Israel. And I will give you rest from all your enemies. Moreover, the Lord declares to you that the Lord will make you a house. Your house and your kingdom shall be made sure forever before me, and your throne shall be established forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is from Romans, the 16th chapter. Now, to God, who is able to strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery that was kept secret for long ages, but is now disclosed, and through the prophetic writings is made known to all the Gentiles, according to the command of the eternal God, to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to rise as you are able. The Holy Gospel according to the first chapter of Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who is said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." And then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And then the angel departed from her.
This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated for a few moments of reflection and silence.
The Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
Dana and Trevor, for Alyssa and Danny, for Lori and family, for the Tulsa Point family, for Keith and Rita and Seth, for Mel and family, and Sean and family, for Jane, for Rose and Jack, for Luke and Karen and Jim, for Nancy, for Kent, for Amber, for Sean, for Siri and Kate, for Claire, for Chris, for Darlene, for Alex and Grace, for Mel, for all of those traveling, and for all those we now name silently in our own hearts. God of endless blessings, we thank you for bringing us safely into this new day. Give us compassion and courage that all we do this day might be a faithful and joyous offering to you, that we might serve you and all your children in loving stewardship of your wondrous creation. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Christ, who taught us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
May the peace of the baby Christ be with you here this morning.
And also with you.
Let's take a moment and share God's peace with each other.
Thank you.
your love, that our faith shines ever new, and our lives reveal your light.
Amen.
A shoot has sprung from Jesse's tree.
O God, the chosen one.
A branch of knowledge and of truth.
A gift of love has come.
Today, as we anticipate the coming Savior, we also remember. And at this time, as the additional readers come forward, if you have an ornament to place on the tree, we'll have you do that as each petition is read. The first five or six of you specifically, you know your order, so if you weren't one of the first five or six ornaments, just wait until the next petition comes, so we kind of have a constant coming forward and adorning of the tree.
We remember Jesus, the branch that grows from lifeless stump of a world, sent by God to redeem what has been lost.
Jesus was part of the Godhead from the very beginning, when the heaven and the earth were first created.
Seeking out Adam and Eve after they sinned. Today he is still seeking the lost, and he seeks us.
We remember the waters that flooded the earth, cleansing it from the sinful. Jesus' blood washed away our sins once and for all.
Abraham's obedience, God's plan of redemption begins to take shape.
Just like God provided a substitute for Isaac, he has provided a substitute for us, the very Lamb of God who take away the sin of the world.
When Joseph's brothers sought to harm him, God used it for good. The cross is the ultimate example of God creating good out of the evil plans of man.
The blood of the Lamb saved the Israelites from the 10th plague. The blood God saves us still.
God gave the Ten Commandments to teach the Israelites to become the kind of people God wanted them to be.
Make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you
and give you peace. This blessing is still being passed on to us as we meet for worship.
Through Rahab, God showed that he can use anyone in his redemption story. No one is beyond the reach of his saving arms.
Once a shepherd, but now a king, David is the one God promises will have descendants on the throne forever. Jesus is that shepherd king.
Boaz was the kinsman redeemer of the two destitute and lost women. God is still in the business of redeeming the lost.
Mordecai knew that deliverance for his people was sure for his people. Esther helped deliver them for a time, and Jesus delivers us for eternity.
Job suffered horribly, but through it all, he knew that he had a Redeemer he would someday meet face to face. In Christ, we can have the same hope.
God was with the three friends in the fiery furnace. God is with us today, no matter what fires we may go through.
Jonah's story teaches us that there is no sin that God can't forgive. God is the God of second chances.
John the Baptist is predicted to turn hearts to God. The Redeemer is coming, but first, we must wait. After 400 years of silence, God is ready to speak, even if Zechariah cannot.
John the Baptist would prepare the ears of the people to follow Jesus.
As we near the end of our Advent journey, we remember the story that leads to the Incarnation, which is the story of grace and second chances. The story continues tonight as we celebrate the birth of Christ. The story also continues in and through us as we go into the world.
since you're already standing for the blessing, may Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you and scatter the darkness from before your path. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated for some announcements. All right, anyone have anything special? We certainly have some special services yet tonight, so we'll cover those. All right, come on back for Christmas Eve service at 2 o'clock and 5 o'clock if you want to participate in the children's program. I hear it's fantastic, as always, right? Tomorrow, Christmas Day, there will be no service here in this sanctuary. Instead, Kartika is joining Pastor Carolyn Schwantes over at St. Stephen, which is one of the downtown churches, and that service is at 9 o'clock, as we are accustomed to, so go there instead of here, if you would. We'd love to see you there. Anyone have anything else? All right, then. Other than, Merry Christmas, especially to our staff. Thank you to both of you for all the amazing things you have done, especially in the last couple of weeks here, to help us all prepare. We thank you for your leadership and your guidance. And now, centered in Christ, Good Shepherd will
gather in blessings, grow in purpose, go in passion.
Please go in peace and be the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.